Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about transaction analysis in Marg ERP and in which we will learn how you can generate customized reports, how to set filter in the reports as per your requirement and compare various reports etc. For which you will go to daily reports to sale report and then to transaction analysis. So in this way a sale purchase analysis window will appear. The first option here is format, which means that whichever customized reports that you will create by applying filters according to your requirement and save it. Those reports gets displayed to you in the format list, and then whenever you want to use these reports, then you can simply go to format and select it. So in this way, you would not have to set filters again and again to generate the report. Next option is analysis, which means that you want to analyze the report on which basis, like company, item, area, route, party, etc. Suppose, let us select company. Now as we have selected the company, and now in versus, we will select that on the behalf of the company what you want to analyze, like company versus item or company versus parties, etc. Suppose you are doing sale in the company, and if you want to see to which parties has been sold in that particular company, so for that you can select parties. Similarly, if you want to see that which items has been sold in which particular company, so you can select those items. And in this way, you can select what you want to analyze in company versus. Let us now select item. After this, you will select what you want to analyze, like sale analysis, sale scheme register, sale and purchase analysis and purchase scheme register. The difference in these is that while doing sale analysis and purchase analysis, you can view quantity, free quantity, amount, tax amount, return quantity, return amount, return tax amount, breakage expiry quantity and amount, cost amount and profit, etc. While doing sales scheme register and purchase scheme register analysis, you can view quantity, amount, free quantity, free amount, discount, scheme, bill discount, MRP value, tax amount, cost amount, profit, etc. And while doing sale and purchase analysis, you can view sale and purchase amount, tax amount, return and breakage expiry, etc. So for example, let us select sale analysis. Then you will select that you want to view the report in summary or in detail. After this, you will specify the period that you want to view the report, from which date till which date. Now here, the filter is zero. This means that if there are some items which have not been sold, then if you will click here, then the items with zero value will also be displayed to you. Similarly, there are few other filters here, like if you want to view detail of a particular company in the company, then simply you will click on the company, and then here a list of companies will appear. And now you can select that particular company here whose details you want to view. In this way, there is salt and HSN. Then is item, and you can use item with another filter as well. Like here is salt and HSN. These have connectivity with item, means they are used with item. Suppose we select HSN and then select done. Then after this, when we will come to item, then you can see that the HSN which we have selected, the items of those HSN is displayed here. So in this way, vice versa filters are applied in this. After this, we will clear the HSN filter and then click on item. So all the items will be displayed. Similarly, if you have set narcotic, schedule H or schedule H1 in the items, then these options will also be displayed to you here. Then from here, you will select the class of items that you want to see. Like if you want to see narcotic items, then you will select narcotic and click on select. Then all the narcotic items will be selected and be displayed on the top. In this way, you can also view schedule H and schedule H1 items. Now, here is area and route, which is used on the basis of party. Then is account group. Suppose you want to filter party of a particular group, then you will go to account group. Like we select sundry debtors and sundry creditors and click on done. And then come to party. Then you can view the sundry debtors and sundry creditors are displayed here. And if you want to only view sundry debtors or sundry creditors, then you can also select it from here. After this, when you will remove account group filter and then come to party, Then you can see that account group are also displayed to you here. And you can select a particular account group here and filter the parties. There are also few filters which are displayed on the basis of control panel or company trade. Like if your company trade is chemist, then you can view two more filters, that is doctor and patient. Next is values, and in this you can filter the report in the basis of values. Then is sales return, means the report that will be generated after filtration. In that report, what do you want to view, like sale minus sales return minus breakage, or sale minus sale return, or sale, etc. Now is stock less, means if you want to view vouchers of stock issue or stock receive, then you will select yes, or if you want to only view stock issue or stock receive, then you will select only. In this way you can use other filters. Now let us generate sale analysis summary report on the behalf of company, for which we will click on show from here. So you can view that the report has been generated, and in this it is displayed that which items are sold in which company. You must also remember that the columns in report will be displayed according to the report that you will generate. After this, if you want to save this report, then you will simply click on save report format. Then you will mention the name of the report as per your requirement and then save it. Now when you will come to format, then you can view that the format that we have just saved is displayed here. And now whenever you want to view company versus item report, then you can simply select the format from here and click on show. After this, if you want to view further detail of any company or item, then you will simply press enter or click here. Like we press enter on Elder India, now you will select that in which format you want to view the detail. Suppose let us select month wise, then you can view the month wise details here. In this way you can also press enter key to select the format. Suppose we select bill wise from here, then you can view the bill wise details. And if you will enter on any particular bill here, then that particular bill will be displayed to you. Now here you can view the column filter. As here you can view many columns, and it might be possible that you would not need few columns. Then in that case you can filter the columns. So from here you will deselect the columns that you don't need, like we have deselected return quantity, return free quantity, return amount and return tax. Now let us click on done, and you can now view that the columns that we have deselected are removed. Then again let us come to column filter. If you want that, you can change the heading of any particular column from here. Along with this, if you want to move any column, like we want to view amount and tax amount column first, then we will firstly come to amount field and click on up arrow. And in this way we will also move tax amount, then click on done. After this, there are different formats here in which you can print your reports. Like if you want to preview the report in GUI format, then you will click on GUI view. So you can view its preview. In this way, if you want to export your report in Excel, then you will click on Excel. Now here the software will ask you that you want to use grid view print in Excel or not. Suppose click on yes. Then here a location will be displayed to you in which the Excel file will be saved. Click on OK, and you can view that the Excel file has been generated. Now again we will click on Excel and select no from here. Then an operation window will appear, and here you will select that how the items will appear on the behalf of company and what values which will be displayed in it. As suppose we select amount and click on done, then the Excel file that will be generated will have a column of amount in it. In this way, if you want that a column of sale quantity should appear in which free quantity must be deducted, then in free quantity you will select the operation minus. Besides this, if you want, then you can also select other operations as per your requirement. After this, you can view print column as per item, which means that if you want to display multiple values of a single item, or if you want to enable operation in a single column, like if you want to display both quantity and amount, then you will select multiple, or if you want to display quantity minus free quantity, then you will select single. Let us now select single. Along with this, you can also mention the number of items to be printed on a single sheet. Now let us click on done, and the location on which the Excel file is saved is displayed here. Then click on OK, And you can view that the Excel file is generated, and along with this, the operation is also displayed to you, that is sale quantity minus free quantity, and that the values displayed to you here have been calculated on this basis. So in this way, you can generate Excel on the basis of different operations. After this, let us select multiple. And basically, in multiple, for every item, an individual column is generated. Now, as we select sale quantity, free quantity, amount, and tax amount. And now the location on which the Excel file will be saved is displayed here. Now click on OK. So now you can view that for every company-wise item, sale quantity, free quantity, amount, and tax amount is displayed. With this, if you scroll the sheet to the right side, then you can view that the total of sale quantity, free quantity, amount, and tax amount is also generated. After this, suppose you want to view that which items of a particular company have not been sold, then for this, you will firstly analyze party versus item, and then mention the period and click on other filter and select the company of which you want to view non-saleable items. And you must remember that you can view non-saleable items of a single company only. For example, let us select Elder India. Click on Done and then click on Show. After this, as we now have to generate its Excel file, then we will click on Excel and then click on No. Then select Multiple, and for example, we select here sale quantity and amount. Now you can view that the software is asking you that you want to print non-saleable items or not. We will click on Yes. And now the location on which the Excel file will be saved is displayed here. Now click on OK. And you can view that the Excel file is generated and the list of the items which have not been sold are also displayed. After this, you also have an option of compare, through which you can compare reports of different periods. Simply, you will click on compare box here and then specify the period of which you want to view the report and then click on show. So a report will be generated and the values displayed in black color are of the current period and the values in gray are the old values through which you are comparing. And in this way, you can compare the report of a particular period. So friends, in this video, you have learned how to generate customized reports as per your requirement through transaction analysis in Marg ERP. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to Marg Tutorial YouTube channel and press this bell icon so you can stay updated with latest videos.